Good morning, everyone. It is Annie Poirier from Shaping Perspectives, and I'm sharing at Annie's Aha. Normally, I am on the beach with a sunrise and the ocean behind me, so this is what I have for you today, a little beach scene, because it is 0 degrees outside, and my phone doesn't appear to really like it when it's 0 degrees outside. So I'm here sharing you my Annie's Aha in my warm office. And I wanted to share with you a little bit about your own pain, criticism, judgment, and comparison. The things that trigger you. The things that trigger you because there's something inside of you that connects meaning to whatever that trigger is. So when someone on the outside triggers you, an experience triggers you. I mean, it's an interesting word, trigger, but that's for another day. But that's kind of the word of today's society. That is an opportunity and an awareness to check in with yourself. What might be happening on the outside? What experience might be happening on the outside that is within you that has not been looked at or has not been seen or has not been brought to the surface? It's been kind of stuffed down. So when we think about our own pain, judgment, criticism, comparison, any of those things, it usually stems from something in our childhood. It comes from a belief system and an identity that we formed when we were younger from the things that we experienced, from the things that we heard from our parents or teachers or friends, experiences that we had that connected to other things. And because we believed them, because why wouldn't we? We're children. We held on to them. They've protected us and they've helped us through our journey until we realize that they're actually not who we are. So a pattern, I should have felt this way instead of this way. I shouldn't have felt sad because of that or angry or frustrated. I should have felt this way. So there's the should and the shouldn'ts, right, that come flooding in. But we've created identities within ourselves from our past experiences. Our past experiences are just experiences that happened in the past. They are not happening now, which means we do not have to identify with that now. I have no idea if this is making any sense, but this is what I was thinking about this morning, and I wanted to share with you. You are not your thoughts. You are not the beliefs that you have held on to for years. I challenge you to question what you believe, because what you believe responds with how you behave. And so I question what you believe. Any I am statements, any you are statements, any limiting beliefs that you hold on to, I ask you to question them. Byron Katie talks, in her work about, is it true? Is it absolutely true? Whether it's true or not. Usually it's not true, absolutely. But even if it is, how do you feel? What behaviors, what emotions, what things connect to you when you believe that's true? And then who would you be without the thought? Who would you be without the belief? And so I challenge you to question your beliefs, to become aware of your triggers, and to start to question those as well. Don't think of them as external triggers. Pull them into you as internal. What is it about that that's bothering me and why? A little bit of self-discovery. This is not easy work, but it's checking in with who you are, what you believe and why you believe it and where did it come from, and then seeing if you can look at it from a different perspective, because that's what I do, that's what we do, is we start to look at things from a different perspective. Because if I see it a different way, I think about it differently, I believe something different, and then I behave differently, which leads to different outcomes. Shaping your perspectives on your own pain, your own frustration, your own criticism, your own judgment, your own thoughts. There you go. From my warm, cozy office. In the beach. Have a great day, everybody. Thanks for watching.